Welcome back. We're here with my good friend Andy Samberg.
Killer band.
Killer band.
Killer band. Great. Yeah. I gotta say, Fred, you look great.
Fred's not there.
You look great,
Fred
man.
Fred is not there.
Marnie Stern, big fan. Good
nice.
To see you. Yeah. And always happy to see Cool Seth.
Don't call him Cool
yeah.
Seth. Our guitarist, Cool Seth.
Cool Seth.
So I want to talk about Brooklyn Nine-Nine, one of my favorite shows on TV. You're so great.
I love you.
I went to the Golden Globes, and the best one of you, Andre Brower has been one of my favorite actors forever.
Yeah.
Loved him on Homicide, Life on the Street. Here, yeah. Now he's in a show with you, which
yes.
I think is hilarious.
It is.
And I went up to him and was like, I just am so happy. I've been a fan of yours for so long. I love that you're working with Andy. And he just looked at me like totally deadpan. He's like, I've learned a lot from your good friend, Andy Samberg. And I thought he was doing a bit, but then he wasn't.
No, he's
just
real.
Learned a lot from you.
Yeah, I teach him every day about the craft and, no,
it's
he's
such
way
a good show. You have
way
such an incredible cast.
Yeah, we got a killer crew, our writers. The whole thing is so fun to do.
Now, the best thing about the Golden Globes, I was presenting in the category you were nominated for.
Yeah.
Which we were talking about, that's just hilarious.
Yes.
And I was thinking about doing like a big old joke, like as I read your name as one of the nominees.
Right.
And then I was out there with Julie Bowen from Modern Family, who's great. It was her job to read the winner.
Right.
Yeah, Julie Bowen, great. You're gonna really applaud her here. Because to her credit, when we opened the envelope and it was your name, she held it for me to read.
Yeah.
So I had this great moment of getting to read my friend's name, which was just an outstanding moment.
And you said best night ever.
Best night ever.
Which I'm sure the other nominees loved.
Yeah. I actually did kind of go around to all of them afterwards. I'm like, hey, he's a really good friend.
I was in his wedding.
It's like, yeah, so.
The best part for me, just walking up on that stage, the look on your face was like I was your son or brother or something. You were like, so excited.
I was so excited.
I think there's a really good picture of it that's like over my shoulder. There you are.
I am so happy.
Pure glee.
Yeah.
Can we tighten it on it? I just want to see more. Yeah.
Oh, no. Very enthusiastic Little League coach.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the best thing about Seth is like, you think, oh yeah, it's a Golden Globe, that's such a huge deal. But he's just like that with me and all his friends. He's so supportive, you know, like, you've been that way at other things recently. Like, me and my wife, Joanna, were at the Vanity Fair party after the Oscars, and, I mean, can we see that, too? There you are in the background.
Yeah. I was happy to see you guys. You look
so
great.
Psyched.
I was really happy, yeah.
And I'm like, it's just the carpet, man. But you were like, no, I'm so proud of you! And then, like, here's one with me and Bill Hader watching Laser Cats. You're watching us.
Okay. No,
Yeah.
I know for a fact that's not real.
That's a real, you love no. Laser Cats.
Yeah, that's not true.
there's a few more, I think. Can we see the next one? This is just you watching Phoebe Cates.
Okay.
In Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
I was excited.
Yeah.
I think everybody was excited when that happened.
You could replace any man's head into that
photo. I'm fine with that one.
But this one I was actually kind of surprised by. I didn't know that this is where your politics fell, but you at Putin's last speech.
Yeah. He, you can tell, is not as happy that I'm
no,
there.
No, he's like...
He said when we went up there, he's like, just be cool. And then I immediately was like so happy.
Yeah, that was moments before he ripped his shirt off.
Yeah.
You know, we've been friends a long time, and this is actually the last one of how supportive Seth's been. The moment I was born.
Yeah.
The moment I was born, he was there.
Yeah.
That's so great. Psyched. And in a tux, which I appreciate.
Well, that was
it's nice of you to dress up for the occasion.
Yeah, I thought, you know what? When am I going to see one of my best friends get born again?
Yeah.
That
was time traveling Seth.
That was time traveling Seth. Real quick, I called you out on it during the show last week.
Yeah.
I have an adorable dog, Frisbee.
Yeah, you have a dog.
I have a dog. You met my dog when she was like a two-month-old puppy, and you just basically said no thank you.
Yeah. Well, Frisbee is a dog.
Yeah.
Who, to me, looks kind of rat-like.
Yeah.
And I lived in New York a long time, and I don't get down on rats.
Right. I believe you told my wife...
This is so awful.
...that you had seen rocks that were cuter than
Frisbee. Yeah! To my credit, when I said that to her, I never thought you'd be saying that I said it on national television.
Right, that's true. It's so great to have you back at 30 Rock. I'm so happy to have you in the
buddy.
Building. It's
this
awesome having you here. Due to my dog. Check out Andy on Brooklyn Nine-Nine, Tuesday nights on Fox.